skin is your largest organ on your body. It's made of billions of cells that can turn into some pretty crazy things. You would be surprised at some of the growths that I see. My name is Dr. Sandra Lay. I'm a dermatologic and cosmetic surgeon, but I'm most well known for my other name, Dr. Pimple Popper. I've performed thousands of procedures for my YouTube channel alone.
Congratulations for surpassing 1 million subscribers.
But that's really a fraction of what I've done overall in my career. Even though a lot of doctors don't want to deal with these lumps and growths, I will be here for my patients because it's become my passion.
That is awesome! Oh my gosh!
But if a bump grows out of control, it can really interfere with your life.
I can't wear like tank tops because I want to hide it.
I'd say the biggest thing it's affecting is my dating life.
And it can even ruin your life.
I can't be fully intimate. I'm too scared to take off my shirt.
I became homeless and hopeless. Nobody to give a lending hand.
Over the last 15 years, I've helped thousands of patients understand their skin better. And in the process, allowed them to take back their lives.
My name's Angelina Johns. I'm 30 years old, and I have a large lipoma growth underneath my left breast. I went to one doctor, and from there it was all kinds of different doctors all over, all kinds of different referrals. And at the end, I was still getting so tired and frustrated with not getting the source taken care of, and I just gave up. When I'm in public, I wear really baggy shirts. I try to keep my purse tucked right below my chest area, just so people can't see, because then when I feel like it's sticking out, I get self-conscious.
Can I get a decaf?
When I first felt the lump, it was like the size of a pea. A few years later, it started to grow into the size of a golf ball. From a golf ball, it went larger. So I have this large softball-sized lump underneath my left boob.
Dr. Lee, it's nice to meet you.
Thanks too
for coming out here and seeing me.
Okay, you have a bump on your stomach. Okay, how long have you had this?
5-6 years.
5-6 years mm-hmm. or so? Okay. And then it's just been slowly, gradually growing?
Yeah.
A lipoma is really a fat cell that decided to divide upon itself and have a little party. Anyone can get a lipoma. Some people get multiple lipomas, and some people, this runs in their family, that they get multiple lipomas.
So it's pretty large.
Okay, my hands are freezing. I'm okay. So sorry about that.
When Dr. Lee was examining my lump, she was very gentle. Definitely made sure that I felt comfortable, you know, lifting up my shirt and examining it.
This is quite a large bump. I mean, it's not as big as I've seen some of them, but I think that the main reason that this is so upsetting to her is because of where it is. It really looks like it's a third boob.
Hey, you do have a little bump under there, huh? I'm gonna just feel around on you.
There's something that moves around under the skin. In fact, if I move it, you can see it. See it shifting right there? So there is something under there. It moves around. The fact that something is hard there really makes me suspect there's possibility that there's something bad going on here. It is a little bit bigger than I expected here, so I think what we need to do is we need to prepare ourselves for this. One of my keys to my existence, really, is to just make sure people are comfortable, because that's the difference between what I do and what like a general surgeon or a plastic surgeon or other people in surgery do. We do things under local anesthesia. That's it, was that bad?
No.
Yeah, that's it. Just like that. Just relax. Keep breathing, okay? A lot of nice deep breaths you want to get. You don't want to hyperventilate. You just want to get good oxygen to you. That's all you need. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do what's called the tumescence, okay? And it's the same kind of thing here. You just feel more like a little tightness more so, okay? And I'll tell you when I'm doing something. Is it on pretty low? Okay, good.
What's interesting about lipomas is they like to find the nooks and crannies of our body. It's like a big blob that grows and it just finds room to grow into. And when it doesn't have any space underneath, it grows up and that's when you see it.
Just gonna see if I can give it a squeeze and see if I can pop it out of here. You okay? I know, yeah. I'm pushing on you.
That's okay.
I'm gonna jiggle you around because a lot of times when I shake it, it'll kind of ease its way out too.
As soon as I removed that lipoma, I immediately examined that hard spot to see what it was. And I was reassured because this looks like it's just scar tissue.
I would send this piece in, but still send the whole thing to pathology.
A pathologist is a type of doctor that examines tissue and gives you a diagnosis. Even though I'm 99% sure that that hard spot is likely scar tissue, I'm gonna send that to the pathology lab to get confirmation.
So, remember we had a large lump below my chest. So now, it's gone. I feel so much better about myself. Tony is very supportive about the entire situation. I definitely feel like I can be myself and confident in a romantic way. Unlike before, I don't have to, you know, hide my stomach or try to hold down the lump, you know, that way they don't feel it or don't see it. Thanks to Dr. Lee, I definitely feel like I've got my groove back. I'll never look at raw chicken the same again. That is so gross. I'm just so grateful that I have the opportunity to start a new life, a healthy, better life.
Yay!